Hi there, I'm David Avant, photographer at photogdavid.net and mdmaphoto.com. I don't know about you, but I hate it when people upload unfinished work to Facebook. In this video series, I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily make proofs using Photoshop that aren't too watermarked to see, but are watermarked enough to know that your property is safe. Alright, so starting out in Photoshop, you want to create a new document. This document is going to be 5,184 pixels by 5,184 pixels if you're shooting with the same size images that I am. You're going to paint your background gray so that you can see both black and white text. And you're going to go back to black and write your statement up top. My statement has three parts to it. It says, proof only, copyright David Avant, not for internet use. So we're going to left align this. I used 160 font so that it would show up almost all the way across the screen. I could have probably made it fit one full time across the screen, but I'm too lazy. Doesn't matter anyways, because we're going to have multiple layers here. So once you've done that, you want to duplicate your layer here. If I can click on the right place. And we're going to stagger it so that the second part of the statement is aligned left. We're going to duplicate again. Oh, I rasterized. That's okay. I'm going to have to do that later anyways. So we're going to duplicate the layer again and put the third statement aligned left. And then we're going to rasterize all layers, merge the text layers, duplicate the layers, and drag them over so that it goes all the way across the screen, repeating your statement. I'm going to merge those and duplicate that. Alright, that'll cover your light background pictures, but what about the dark backgrounds? The black's not going to show up. So we're going to invert that layer, and that's going to be in white. Now that we have our black and white, we can merge these and duplicate them down the screen. Again. And do it again. We should be good after this set. Alright, so now all the way down your screen it says proof only, copyright, your name, not for internet use. And it says it everywhere in black and white. We're going to merge these layers, and I usually set my opacity down to about 30%. You can set it however much you want, because you can change that once you actually set up your action. Now we're going to save this as, actually we need to make sure the background is not visible, because you don't want to just have a gray background on all of your pictures. So we'll save this as a PDF. We'll call it proof.pdf. I already have one, so I'm going to overwrite. You don't have to do that. My computer will go. It's going to say in the settings you choose to save. I don't feel like reading it. Just hit OK. And hit Save PDF. Yes. Once it finishes saving, you've got your proof watermark done.